Deputy Shane Ross.
Answer that.
Deputy Shane Ross, please. Thank you. I called Deputy Shane Ross. Deputy Shane Ross, please. Thank you.
Can I call it? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Deputy. Keep going.
Thank you, can I call it? The Taoiseach will be aware, no doubt, after his rallying cry about the economy, of the IMF report that was issued last night, which was a pretty devastating report, not just about the global economy, but particularly about Europe. And indeed, the chief economist of the IMF said that it was time for Europe to get its act together. And that's pretty strong words for an international body like that. This follows when Tim Geithner went to the US Treasury Secretary, went to Poland last weekend where the Minister of Finance was, and he gave them a similar message. And the message coming out from outside Europe is that Europe is an economic swamp and that it is sinking and that it has no leadership. And I'd like to ask the Taoiseach this. Is he happy with the solution to each European crisis, which appears to be that Chancellor Merkel and President Sarkozy get together, they meet, they met in May, June, they achieve nothing, they met in July, they achieve nothing, they met in August, they achieve nothing, and they met by telephone last week and achieved absolutely nothing. Who gave them this authority to pose as the voices of Europe, meeting together in a high-profile situation and coming out and giving the appearance, and deliberately so, that they have solved the European problem? Now, whether we like it or not, partly because the economy has been so mismanaged, we are pivotal players in the recovery of Europe. And what I don't like is what I want to ask the question is this. The IMF recommendation to the immediate solution to the problem was this, and it counters a lot of what the Taoiseach has just said. It said that Ireland, it didn't name Ireland, but all European countries, were going to have to surrender a lot of their economic sovereignty if the problem was going to be resolved. Now, the Taoiseach has just said, and I applaud him for it, that our ambition is to get out of the hands of the IMF and the EU and the Troika and re-establish our economic sovereignty. Is he going to move in the opposite direction and sacrifice that sovereignty, that economic and political sovereignty, Mr. Sarkozy and Mrs. Merkel?
Thank you.
Taoiseach.
I don't have the report from the IMF, Deputy. You're only too well aware that there were frequent denials about the economic state of this country before the IMF arrived here. Let me assure you that the government which I lead has been working assiduously both with the IMF, the ECB and the Commission in terms of the Troika as to changes that we see are both important in this country's interest and in the European Union's interest. I've made the point as a public rep on many occasions that in the past, on political issues, big countries in Europe stood by small countries in Europe in the context of the overall political direction of the European Union. Obviously, given the nature and the makeup of the governments of quite a number of countries, there are difficulties internally with minority governments or support from multi-parties or whatever. No such difficulty exists in this country here. And I make the point to you that at the decisions made in July in respect of the economic situation for the future, we undertook to do certain actions, and we're following that assiduously. And you are correct when you observe that the conversation and the talk now in Europe is about any country that can become successful out of this economic turmoil. And they are all looking now at this country as being one where government and people working together in dealing with the challenge that we face can well be the first to emerge from this situation. And confidence level is rising in Ireland's perception of how we're dealing with this and our reputation abroad. Yes, It is true to say that we've had some work to do in rebuilding that reputation with international business, and that's paying dividends, and the line of investment continues to be very strong. But I think when we look at the issues that have been renegotiated by the Ministers for Finance and the Minister for Public Expenditure, in the context of the Memorandum of Understanding, the IMF and the Troika itself are willing to listen and agree with credible arguments being put up by the government for a change of direction and a change of the emphasis that we put here. Yes, of course, America has its own difficulties, and there are strains in economic turmoil in other parts of the world. Yes, we'd like to think that everything was rosy in the European garden, but the Greek Prime Minister at the July meeting did give very clear assurances that the conditions of the bailout for Greece would be adhered to. There have been changes made there, Ministry for Finance, austerity programmes and so on. Obviously, the austerity programme put through in the case of Italy. But for our part here in Ireland, we are focusing on dealing with what we undertook to do and at the same time grow our economy where we can get back to a point of employment growing, of this country sending out a signal that of all the small countries in the world, this is the one where it's best to do business. And despite the international comments, politics at the end of the day has got to make its decisions for the future. We're making ours, and we're working assiduously with the Troika in our own interests, our people's interests, our country's interests, and indeed Europe's interests.
Thank you.
Thank you, Colin.
One minute.
The Taoiseach might answer the sovereignty issue when he replies to this particular question as well, whether he is prepared to give up the sovereignty as required by the IMF. But the more specific issue is this. Is he happy that Sarkozy and Merkel should be meeting and posing as the spokesman for Europe continuously? The President of France must recognise that in the last week, two French banks have been downgraded. Two out of the three biggest French banks, Crédit Agricole and Société Générale, have been downgraded. And France is in the same swamp as we are at this stage. And for the IMF to suggest that we actually hand over sovereignty to others in a possibly worse situation is something which we must question. We must not be...
Question, please.
Yes. Is the Taoiseach happy to be an impotent spectator in the European solution to this problem, while others in a similar situation are posing as the leaders of Europe? Is he happy for them to be his voice?
Thank you, Taoiseach. 1 minute.
No, I'm not happy, nor do I intend to be, nor will the government be a spectator standing, as somebody more famous than I said one time, standing idly by while all this happens. I would say this to you, Deputy. The IMF are perfectly entitled to make their proposals. They've been very considerate of a number of the propositions put forward by our ministers for finance here, in respect of renegotiation of elements of the memorandum of understanding. It's perfectly in order for Chancellor Merkel and President Sarkozy to meet, as it is for any other leaders. I expect to go to Germany myself to give an update on the progress that we're making here, and indeed to meet the French president when it's appropriate. But obviously these, while both countries are enormously influential, and while Germany in particular sets the base rate here, the Chancellor has made it perfectly clear that Germany will continue to support the euro, and that the eurozone has got to work together to get out of these particular difficulties. So insofar as we're concerned in this Parliament, a measure of our economic sovereignty for the first time ever has been removed from us, because we're not in a position to determine all of the things we would like to do now until we get back to a point where we comply with the conditions of the bailout deal, where we get back to borrowing in the bond markets, and where government itself can determine its own future in working with our people as a country.
Thank you.
The IMF are perfectly entitled to put forward their views and their plans in respect of their view of the future of Europe. We have the Lisbon Treaty signed off on. I don't see any prospect of further treaties up ahead. there's a situation here where we have got to work together, and I want you to understand that insofar as the government is concerned, both at the ECOFIN meetings and at leaders' meetings, we will continue to put forward propositions not just based on the narrow individual interest of Ireland, but on the interests of Europe. And an element of that was accepted in respect of the arguments we were making about the interest rate reduction, that there were countries within the European Union who were getting monies at a much lower interest rate, and that argument was accepted and became the norm.
Thank
which
you.
Resulted in part the reasons why the interest rate reduction has been applied in the way it has been.
Thank you. We now move on to the order of business.